Hello and welcome to The Quest on Raj Sabha TV. I'm Rakhi Bakshi. In this show, you know that we keep talking to leading personalities, and each week we bring you new faces. The person we are talking to right now is a very interesting guest. We must tell you that he holds the highest position as far as Election Commission is concerned. He's the Chief Election Commissioner, somebody who's just taken over, and it is his first major interview that he's giving after taking this top position. We are talking to Mr. H.S. Brahma. Welcome to the show, sir.
Rakhi. Good morning.
And many congratulations.
Thank you.
So how does it feel, sir, now that you've taken on the top position? I mean, do you feel that you have a lot of responsibilities on your head?
Good morning, Rakhi, again. Namaskar to all our voters of our Delhi and all over the country. It's a fact, I really feel humbled and very proud to occupy this post. It's a fact that I'm in this office, Election Commission of India, for last 5 years. Mm. I came here in 2010 August, so I'll be here till April 2015. It is really, you feel happy. Of course, I've been very fortunate to hold certain good, key posts in the Government of India and as well as in the state. Mm-hmm. Before I came here, I was in the Power Secretary Government of India.
But, sir, that you have been an election commissioner already here, so you've seen the system from inside. Now that you take over this position, do you bring an inside view of what should be right and what should not be wrong?
In fact, it is a good training ground. In fact, when I joined in 2010 as a junior election commissioner, I had senior colleagues who are put in more than 5 years, 4 years in the election. In fact, it is a good grooming. In fact, when you spend about 5 years or 4 years, as an election commissioner, is a part of the team, you got to know lots of things. You have a deep insight of what is happening around us. You have a thorough knowledge of problem that we face in conduct of elections. And more importantly, how to satisfy the feelings and also the aspiration of not only political parties, candidates, but also our voters, our people, our all Indians.
Yeah. Do you think Election Commission in itself has really made a long journey from where it started? Now everybody, of course, it's a very credible and esteemed institution, but people are now really understanding the importance of their vote, and Election Commission has done a lot in doing that.
Rakhi, to be frank with you, we have been, as Election Commission, you know, we are here for the last 65 years. You have seen last year's election, 2014, May, June, April, May ka election. If you look back, if I see the history of our Indian election for last, we have done 16 general election last year.
Yeah.
Our parliamentary election of last year is 16th one, 16 parliamentary elections. And we have also done about 350 plus state general elections. Mm-hmm. We are a big country, yeah. We have a big population. You know, what was in 17 crores in 1951-52, mm. When we had the first election in 1951-52, we had a voter strength of only 17 crores. In 1951-52, mein jab humne election ko kiya tha, it was only 17 crores.
And now it has risen to many fold.
Now, if you look today, as on today, I'm talking about the 29th of January 2015, we have voter strength of almost 85 crores. Kahan 17 crores tha, abhi kahan hum pahunch gaye 85 crores. It's a big, huge.
What do you think has contributed to that fact? We are a democracy and we are proud of that. But how do you think that the people's empowerment, that citizen empowerment has come in?
Actually, there is a, if you see the progression of the percentage of voting, jo hamara 1952 mein jo hua raha tha, the people participating in the election, whichever election, state election ho ya apna general election ho, there has been appreciable increase in voter strength and participation. Aap dekhiye hamara 2014 ka jo election hua, usme hamara percentage 66 plus, I would say, and especially the northeastern state like West Bengal ho, Tripura ho, Nagaland, Manipur, even a state like Assam, my state Assam.
Yeah.
They have a high percentage, 80 plus. But generally, if you see the whole India, apna pura Bharat desh ko hum dekhe to, in generally our participation has been going up from every election.
Yeah.
Thanks to I must also thank our political parties, their candidates and their star campaigners, they are also motivating the, our voters, our people to come out and select and elect their best candidate available.
Many things have happened actually, and we'll keep talking about that, but let's also take a look at the recent Delhi elections, because we are in the midst of when it's going on, the poll process is on. What new arrangements Election Commission has made for that?
Rakhi, Delhi election is the one of the, I would say, major election. It is a, though it is only 70 seat. अपना पूरा दिल्ली का जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी है ओनली 70 का नंबर है, 70 कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी है हमारा दिल्ली में, पूरा दिल्ली में. वहाँ पे एक करोड़ 30 लाख का वोटर्स है हमारा
जी,
1.3 करोड़ वोटर्स है हमारा. एंड देयर आर अबाउट स्लाइटली मोर देन 11,000 पोलिंग स्टेशंस. इज अ बिग चैलेंज एंड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, बिकॉज वी हैव रिसेंटली कंडक्टेड द वेरी कॉम्पिटेंटली ऑल द इलेक्शन इन आवर कंट्री, इंक्लूडिंग ऑल स्टेट इलेक्शन ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर अदर वगैरह. बट दिल्ली इलेक्शन एवरी होल वर्ल्ड विल बी वॉचिंग अस, क्योंकि दिल्ली इज द कैपिटल ऑफ आवर कंट्री.
व्हाट यू फील मोर रिस्पॉन्सिबल,
व्हाट इज बीइंग डन इन दिल्ली इज एग्जाम्पल टू द अदर पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, इज अ विंडो टू द वर्ल्ड. अगर हम कहीं मान लीजिए कहीं रिमोट प्लेस हुआ, हमारा पूरा देश में काफी
जगह
काफी दूर है, वी डोंट फील इज 2000 किलोमीटर का आपको तय करना पड़ता है. लेकिन दिल्ली इज इन द मिडिल ऑफ द, वी आर इन द मिडिल ऑफ द हार्ट ऑफ आवर कंट्री.
But that's why your responsibility is, I think, is much more.
बिल्कुल, I mean, Delhi का election, even you make a small mistake, अभी आप मान लीजिए even a very minute mistake, it'll be exponentially, क्या बोलते हैं उसको, आपको बड़ा सा उसको आप बताएंगे भाई ये गड़बड़ हो रहा है, वो नहीं हो रहा है, ये हो रहा है. So the Delhi election is highly concentrated. Not only we are watching, but whole world is watching.
So as the whole world is watching, we'll also be watching this whole Delhi election, and we'll keep talking to you about so many other issues. Right now we are taking a very short break. We are talking to Mr. H.S. Brahma, he's the Chief Election Commissioner. You are watching The Quest on Raj Sabha TV. Don't go away. We are coming back shortly.
कागज पर उतरी रेखाएं, नेता के माथे चिंताएं, ब्यूरोक्रेसी तनी तनी सी, पब्लिक लेकिन खिली खिली सी, लेता है सबकी वो खबर, धारदार है इसकी नजर, नहीं बोलता ये किरदार, लेकिन सब हैं खबरदार, पढ़ने वाले का जीते मन, सिर्फ एक है वही लक्ष्मण. देखिए विरासत में इस बार आर के लक्ष्मण का कार्टून संसार.
वेलकम बैक टू द शो, यू वॉचिंग द क्वेस्ट ऑन राज्यसभा टीवी एंड वी आर टॉकिंग टू मिस्टर एच एस ब्रह्मा, इज द चीफ इलेक्शन कमिश्नर. सो इन दिल्ली इलेक्शंस, व्हाट न्यू वी आर गोइंग टू वॉच सर?
राखी, टू थिंग्स विल हैपन. वन, वी हैव लॉन्च, आपको पता होगा 25 जनवरी को जो हमारा फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट हमारा डॉक्टर कलाम साहब, ही इज लॉन्च दैट आवर वोटर्स डे में हमने एक पोर्टल ओपन रिलीज लॉन्च किया हमने, जिसके द्वारा आप पूरा वर्ल्ड में, आप एनी इंडियन, एनी वोटर्स एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड, आप कहीं भी हो, जहाँ भी आपका इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी होगी, तो यू कैन सिट एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड और एनीवेयर इन इंडिया. अगर मैं दिल्ली में रहता हूँ, मेरा वोट, मेरा रोल हमारा मान लीजिए तमिलनाडु हो या आंध्रा हो या अपना अरुणाचल में हो, बाय देयर पोर्टल यू कैन नो आपका आपका नेम सही है कि नहीं, आपके एड्रेस सही है कि नहीं, वेदर देयर इज सम मिस्टेक इन द एड्रेस या मिस्टेक इन द स्पेलिंग ऑफ योर नेम्स वगैरह, इंक्लूडिंग योर पोलिंग स्टाफ, कहाँ पे जाएंगे आप, कौन सा कॉन्स्टिट्यूंसी में होंगे, कौन सा नाम होंगे आपका. Everything will be known to
what
you.
What you're saying is a very big thing, because one of the problems and complaints that we always heard is that people have problems in electoral rolls and their names not being there. So you think this portal will actually make it all transparent?
Absolutely. आपको सही है कि हम लोग एक हफ्ता पहले, पांच दिन पहले, before 5 days or 4 days, we'll be giving to every voters like anywhere in India. पहले तो हम पूरा हिंदुस्तान में किए, even Delhi also is no exception. हम 4 दिन पहले, 5 दिन पहले, we'll be giving voter slip. जो आप लोग पहले पॉलिटिकल पार्टी या कैंडिडेट देते थे पहले ना, दे हैज टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट देयर स्लिप 2 दिन पहले, 1 दिन पहले, 3 दिन पहले, बट दैट जॉब दे कैन विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम दे कैन डू इट. बट वी हैव टेकन द रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी that we will be giving, suppose मान लीजिए किसी को doubt हो, will be giving the voter slip. Voter slip nothing but the replica of the EPIC card. आप कहाँ पे जाएंगे, किधर डालेंगे, आपका रोल नंबर क्या है, आपका EPIC सीरियल नंबर कौन सा बोथ है, कौन सा पुलिंग जाना पड़ेगा. That is one thing. But one can also see this portal, our portal.
Yeah, and you're making things easy for many other people. Bilkul. For example, people who are physically challenged, you've already started the braille system where I don't know how much is it functioning. How are you trying to strengthen those who are marginalized, who are helpless and who really want to come out?
We have a large number of voters who are very unfortunate. Some have a disability, they have a disability of not able to walk because of AZNA or some physical disability by birth, or some people have a eyesight problem, they cannot see. So those things will be taken care of, like extremely aged person above 70 or 75. He or she will be allowed to go up to the, almost to the last point. Instead of walking, all of us are prevented 100 meters away, 50 meters away.
Okay.
Leave your car, leave your scooter, leave your vehicles. But for these senior citizens of our country, elderly, who requires support, who requires help, assistance from all of us, they'll be directed to go up to the nearest point. Jab tak jahan tak aap ja sakte wahan tak you can go by car.
Okay, or that's
by,
a good thing.
There will be a trailer, there will be, kya bolte usko, three-wheeler, they can go.
And of course, you know, Election Commission is really watching everything meticulously. I mean, I've heard that some of you, the officials, are going to press conferences, monitoring things. One question which of course emerges is that, you know, how some, of course, Election Commission, which is like a watchdog and it's looking at harmony and election which should be conducted peacefully and nicely, at times faces certain kind of problems in terms of some people not really coming up to the mark, but these things of course are sorted out also. How do you really would like to look at it or give a message that how harmony should be maintained?
Like in a democracy, I mean, in any democracy, it gives, in a country like India, our country, we speak 1600 languages. There are 676 jila, district janpada. There are 38 state UTs. We speak different languages. We have different culture, different language, different custom, different religion. What is available in the world is available in our country, maybe more also.
Yeah.
So, democracy gives the best opportunity to every one of us to express.
Yeah.
So, in a democracy, where there is so much of diversity, but in, on the day of election, we are one. Every Indian, wherever they are, either they are in Ladakh or Leh or 15,000 feet mein hamara polling station hai, or even the near the island, Andaman Nicobar jaiye aap, apna Lakshadweep jaiye aap, kafi dur da area hai jahan pe jaane ke liye kafi mushkil hai. You have to cross river, you have to cross stream, you have to cross mountain.
So the commission is very unbiased. Yeah, so the commission is very unbiased and keeping a watch on each and everybody, regardless of anything.
We feel that every Indian, as a proud Indian, we should be allowed to vote, and every facility should be provided for our people to vote without any difficulties, without any obstacle, either physical or otherwise also.
And nobody should be pressurized in any kind.
Bilkul. In a democracy, there is no question of force. The idea of force, threat, or kya bolte aap usko, hindrance, wo bilkul hona nahi chahiye, because it will be very unfortunate at democracy level, great democracy level our country, that we have this kind of problem. But we as Election Commission of Meta, it is our moral and
exactly
responsibility, our duty, and our constitution gives us very clear mandate. You have to conduct absolutely free and fair election. Aap kaise free and fair election karenge, that is our responsibility, both moral and physical.
Because in the heat of this whole poll process, we sometimes hear, and I'm sure things come to you, where people get little charged and sometimes they say things which they should not. But Election Commission has really maintained its moral fabric very strong and looking at everything carefully.
We, as far as we are concerned, I've been here for the last 5 years. I think one of the lessons that I have, I mean, one of the things that we are, as a team election, always you look at is that we want to give 100% neutrality, unbiased opinion, without any fear, without any favor. We look at the issue very to the point, to the straight, and whatever decision has to be given, we look at the straight, at the point, and so legal implication, also the moral implication, ethical value. So our every action we do, every job we discharge, every responsibility we try to take, we ensure that nobody gets unfair deal.
And nobody is so powerful and nobody is lesser powerful. I mean, everybody
is
the
same. Above all. I mean, in democracy, in a country, a liberal democracy, a constitutional country like us, constitution is above us. It implies that law is above all of us. There's nobody above law. Law is above all of us. You know, you understand that.
Yeah.
In so, a country, yes, as sir. A great country like ours, because we are a great country.
That is one thing that we look
because
up
law
to
is great in our country.
Yeah.
Everybody is above
so
law.
So we'll of course keep talking to you, sir, about more such issues. But right now, again, another short break. We are going in for a very short break once again on The Quest. You're watching it on the Rajya Sabha TV. But don't go away. We are still talking to Mr. H.S. Brahma after this very short break.
New government in New Delhi. New faces.
People are not investing because they are scared of your tax administration.
New thinking.
The auction process is a fair and good process.
You cannot have a one-size-fits-all reform policy.
For insights and perspective.
Judiciary should be more concerned about corruption within itself.
The Modi government's slogan of Achhe Din Aane Wale Hain. Soon the people's slogan will be Hamare Purane Din Lauta Do.
The biggest show on economic policy. Watch State of the Economy.
Welcome back to the show. You're watching this conversation with Mr. H.S. Brahma. Sir, looking at social media, empowering the youth and encouraging them to come out, how are you looking at it?
Rakib, I was born in 1950. Internet, digital technology came in 1985. All boys and girls, young boys and girls were born after 80s, 84, 83, 85, niche. They are used to certain environment of technology. They have seen color TV, they have seen digital TV, they have seen internet. So hum log jo, when you join the service, then the things have started coming, but the children who are born, the generation that are born after 80s, are there subject to large number of digital technology, internet technology, social media. Aap dekhenge kya kya ho raha hai. And today also, if you look at the campaigning also, the biggest challenge to the Election Commission of India today, which will be in the foreseeable future, is the use of the latest technology. Aap Delhi mein baith ke pura world ko aap control kar sakte. क्यों नहीं क्योंकि यू कैन गिव ए लेक्चर थ्रू योर वीडियो सिस्टम डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी आप अमेरिका बैठ के पूरा वर्ल्ड को बात कर सकते हैं आई मीन यू हैव बीन सीइंग
सो द होल कंसेप्ट डू यू थिंक ड्यू टू टेक्नोलॉजी एंड द यूथ इज नाउ मोर एंड मोर एनकरेज्ड
टू कम आउट या टुडे आई कैन टेल यू ऑनेस्टली इन 2014 में जो मैं इलेक्शन गया था अपना न्यू मोतीबाग में अपना जो इलेक्शन जनरल इलेक्शन के बारे में हम बोल रहे थे सम यंग बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स वर वोटर जस्ट मस्ट बी कॉलेज का Maybe first year, second year, college boys and they're asking, sir, आप क्यों line में क्यों खड़े हैं? मैं बोले भाई आपकी तरह मैं भी line में खड़े हूँ क्योंकि मेरे को भी बहुत देना नहीं सर यू वी शुड थिंक वाई शुड यू एंड मी शुड स्टैंड फॉर आवर्स आप इज वाई डोंट यू इंट्रोड्यूस द सिस्टम लाइक द टेक्नोलॉजी लाइक वाई नॉट यू इंट्रोड्यूस द इंटरनेट टेक्नोलॉजी और मोबाइल टेक्नोलॉजी अब हम when we are getting money out of that ATM card without the whole thing why not you introduce the, I mean the new generation of people
Yeah.
Number one, they are very, very aggressive
Infused,
in two
yeah.
things. They don't want to waste their time. They always say, we have got better things to do. So, humko bhi ye sochna padega as
And do you think the Election Commission has done a lot in terms of creating awareness? Now, the slogan that you have in Delhi, for example, is Pehle pata karenge, phir neta chunenge.
Know your candidates.
Yeah.
Like KYC. Know your candidates because it is good to know because suddenly you don't if you don't know about you and me then how you decide you see after all he or she has to vote on somebody unless he or she as a voter doesn't know what you and me we are then it will be difficult for him or her to take a choice how to take an informed decision
and taking the issue a little away to areas like northeast and J&K where you have also conducted elections and peacefully also comparatively how really are you gearing up for that I mean in future and how has been the past experience also
actually one I don't know may I may be wrong or may not be correct or my observation may be different but areas of this unfortunate area of central India some of our Naxalite our lefting affected area districts of some 60 70 districts over central India our around 70 80 districts are there roughly I'm not saying exactly some area not fully, some partly, some quarter, like that, different stages. And also J&K and part of Northeast like Nagaland, Mizoram, yeah. Nagaland, Manipur. These are a few areas, a little bit of
disturbance.
But I'm very proud to say they may have a disturbance during normal period. But I'm very proud to say during election, even J&K election, we didn't have any problem. Okay, unfortunately, some outsider tried to create much, but our Indians, our proud Indians, never create any problem. In fact, only thing is that I think one message election commission, all the team election, district and state, is to have a more consultation among our people. You see, the more and more you are open to the people, area, the problem, you discuss with them their problem, then when they are know
that
your mind
that
is very clear, when the minds are very clear, your mission objectives are very clear, you are here to improve their condition, we are not here to occupy their area or create some problem. So I think more open you are, more attentive to their problem, I think.
And of course, now another round of elections will happen after Delhi. You'll be Bihar and other states will also come up. So, anything new and how you're gearing up for that?
I mean, election committee is always prepared. Of course, we prepare during peace, we prepare for the war. You know, in defense services, all of you know it.
Yeah. For the
during
crisis.
Peace, you prepare for the war. So, phase one, last 5 years, 2010-2015, Delhi will be the last election of the last. जो पहला फेज का फाइव ईयरली फेज अनफॉर्च दिल्ली वॉज सपोज टू हैव इलेक्शन आफ्टर फ्यू ईयर्स बट सिंस वी हैड इलेक्शन इन 13 दे शुड कंटिन्यू आफ्टर 2018 वो तो मुश्किल से गड़बड़ हो गया बट नाउ द रियल अगेन फाइव ईयरली बैटल विल स्टार्ट से आफ्टर बिहार इलेक्शन विच विल बी अराउंड द कॉर्नर बाई एंड ऑफ द ईयर सो आई थिंक दिल्ली इलेक्शन विल बी कंप्लीटिंग बाई से बाई आवर 10th ऑफ फरवरी आई थिंक आवर पीपल हैव अ रेस्ट फॉर अबाउट हाफ ए say around 4 to 5 months. Yeah. But that 4 to 5 months is a time, the breathing period, where we will train our boys and ladies. I mean, you all know that the language you always speak, during the peace, you prepare for the war. During war, you cannot prepare. You have to fight a battle.
But
so election commission also, during the 4-5 mahine mein jo time ko time milega, there will be sufficient take care of our requirement for our EVM machine, kahan pe garbar ho raha hai, kidhar garbar ho raha hai, apna role ka mamla kise karenge. All this reform, management, technology, training, quality building, team building, leadership quality, pura ye 4-5 mein humko karna padega. And most important, the quality of role has to improve. And now, the technology we are going to use, we are going to have this. I told you, na, that our EPIC card will be on the platform of EPIC card, jo hum bana rahe hain aapke liye, sab hum distribute kar chuke hain. उसके ऊपर अभी विल बी इम्पोजिंग आवर आधार के इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन दैट सो दैट मीन्स दैट इफ राखी इज ओनली राखी का आपका पूरा बायोमेट्रिक आई और आईज आईरिस वगैरह होगा तो इफ समबडी से आई एम राखी यू कैन ओनली चेकअप विद
योर
आवर आधार our UIDAI system, then we know who is or who is not.
Yeah, so as we are wrapping up, a final message from the Chief Election Commissioner to the voters who are going to vote.
Now my appeal to all my voters about Delhi election, also other by election in the remaining states, there are some state by election, parliamentary election our in our Bangaon in West Bengal, and also we have got elections in 5 states. My appeal to all, including Delhi election, is that it is a responsible job. Voting is a responsible job because through the voting you will elect, you will select and elect the right candidate. The right candidate, when he or she goes to assembly or parliament, will take care of your interest. So you elect your leader who will take care of you in your parliament or assembly. Indirectly, you rule yourself. आप जिसको आदमी को आप elect करके चुन के आप भेजेंगे parliament हो या assembly Delhi assembly हो या कहीं पे हो गया, he'll be representing your views, your mind, your interest. Indirectly in the democracy क्या हम क्या करेंगे क्या what is the meaning is that throw your candidate. You rule yourself.
Yeah, that's a very good line you're saying.
आपका जो what you say.
You want to rule yourself. हाँ,
what you say in Hindi. आपका जो क्या बोलते ख्वाहिश होंगे, आपका जो demand होंगे, आपका जो recommend होंगे.
Desire.
आप आपके जो desire होंगे, you'll be putting your all desire in your candidate, who in turn will represent you in the parliamentary assembly. उसके बाद that means you can say भाई देखो हम आपको चुन के हम भेजा आपको हमारे तरफ से आपको भेजा हमने. तो आप बिल्कुल हमारे हमारे लिए काम करना पड़ेगा.
अगर आप नहीं काम करेंगे एनी अब्यूज विल आल्सो बी वर्किंग दिस टाइम. यू कैन टेल देम दैट हाउ
इट इज. वी दैट्स व्हाई आवर स्लोगन यू नो योर कैंडिडेट्स. तो मेरे ख्याल से नाउ एवरीथिंग इज ऑनलाइन, एवरीथिंग इज ऑन द वेबसाइट. यू कैन आवर आई अपील टू ऑल माय कैंडिडेट, ऑल माय वोटर्स, ऑल माय आवर सिटीजंस. लुक एट देयर बैकग्राउंड, लुक एट देयर क्वालिटी, लुक एट देयर एंटीसीडेंट्स. यू चूज योर बेस्ट कैंडिडेट हु विल डू समथिंग फॉर यू एंड सो दैट while you vote, you also expect something in return for the welfare of
and
the country.
And you feel happier.
So that you are part of. So indirectly in democracy, you elect the leaders, elect your candidate in such a manner that you directly, indirectly rule yourself.
Yeah, that's a very good line you are saying, and thanks a lot,
thank
sir,
you,
for
you,
saying
thank you,
all
you,
this spending
brother.
Time. Many congratulations to you and to the election.
Naya Saal ke aapko Mubarak. Wish you all the best.
And that was very nice talking to you here on the Quest on Rajya Sabha TV. And that was Mr. H.S. Brahma, the Chief Election Commissioner, talking to us on Rajya Sabha TV. As we said, that this was his first major interview after taking over as Chief Election Commissioner. I hope you like this particular edition of the Quest. Thanks for watching. Namaskar and bye.